Hello. Welcome back to the 12 Days of Christmas. We're just catching up on a little more on holiday reading. While I'm waiting on the video that you're about to see to render. So on this, the 10th day of Christmas, science gets to be something frankly special for us. To give you a little behind-the-scenes look at the way Science Day records is we record a lot of stuff, and I don't delete any of it. I picked up this technique from hearing how the angry video game nerd produces stuff. We don't delete anything. I just archive it onto external hard drives, or I've got a NAS system at home, 10 terabytes. I can just, when hard drives fill up, I just file that stuff away. That way, if we ever need anything, or something that didn't work out at the time, you want to reach back into the archive, pull something out, I have the option to do that. This video isn't 100% that kind of video. This is something I've been working on off and on, and to show you how much I've been working off and on, I've left my edit intact for the opening title card, where I crossed out the amount of time that had passed since the footage was recorded. So you'll see about the time you're watching this now, it's actually been 4 years since we initially recorded this. Yes, I know that's an incredibly long time, and you're probably wondering, why did it take me so long to edit this video? Simple fact is, anytime Tesla or the Darwin make a joke on, oh, we should put this in post, I'm going to do it. And unfortunately, the joke that was made in this particular video necessitated head tracking, which I use Camtasia as an editor, and it does not have head tracking. So I basically had to frame by frame animate this, and don't get your hopes up here. I'm going to flat out tell you, it's some janky animation, but it's it fits the style of what I was going for. I'm happy that I finally got it done and I'm able to put it out here during the 12 Days of Christmas. Really, I think above all, this is my gift to the Tesla and the Darwin. This is just a fun moment we had together, having some good laughs, and I wish we could have gotten out of this sooner, and I'm just glad I can finally give it to you now. This is my Christmas gift to you guys. So, enjoy. But the rest of you, enjoy it too. So, sit back. Enjoy. Till next time, stay classy, Internet. And with that, Scientist Say proudly presents, after 4 years, the Clamato Chug. Enjoy.
Hey everyone, I'm Sagan.
I'm the Tesla.
And I'm the Darwin.
And we are Scientists Say.
And this contains 38% juice.
And this...
Or says, contiene 38 de juego. Hugo.
And this...
Hugo.
And this...
Information.
And this...
Juan Vase!
And this...
946 milliliters.
This is the Clamato Chug.
Cultivo de tomate de concentrado. Clamato el original.
Quit Stalin. Quit Stalin.
Putin. Quit Putin. Rasputin. Alright, yep. All right. We found here a bottle of Clamato juice, and it's picante.
But we didn't get any sombreros.
No, but I think right about now... With a ding sound effect, we will have sombreros.
But when mine goes on,
you won't be able to tell.
I would prefer the sound effect that lowriders have instead of horns.
You mean the La Cucaracha?
Bet your ass.
I don't think we can make that happen.
Sorry, Hispanic community.
It's hilarious.
Okay.
Go.
I didn't know I had a mustache too. Sweet.
Where's my poncho? Shut up, dick.
All right, let's.
I'm the Meg in this relationship.
So we're Shut gonna up, Meg. We're gonna do a pseudo jackass bit here.
Don't call it pseudo jackass. Just say Joel's gonna. I mean, Tesla's gonna chug some Clamato and see how far he can get.
Tesla's gonna chug some Clamato and see how far.
Spicy Clamato.
Spicy. Here, let's show them the label. We're not Greek in this one.
Pay us, bitches.
Conte Clamato. Yeah, pay us for advertising your terrible beverage that shouldn't exist.
All right, I did have a sip earlier to see if Clamato was would give me the clamp, and it did, but I think I can make it work. Did I say the clamp? I meant the clap. And clamps. All right, let's see how far I can get. We should be playing La Cucaracha as I'm doing this.
God, or what is it, the Ecstasy of Gold from the Good, Bad, and the Ugly?
No, he's talking about the...
Well, you'll know it when it gets put in post.
Exactly.
Thank you, post.
All right.
Like dick cheese.
Clamato. Burns like dick cheese. If they weren't gonna pay us before, they sure as hell aren't now. But you know what might help that? A soothing orange creamsicle from Arby's. Arby's, hook it up.
Today's episode brought
to you by Arby's. I'll even take a free curly fry.
Yeah, free value.
God.
Yes, because it is one curly fry with a value.
Right?
6'4". Can't get by on that. Value curly fry.
The only thing I value more than this is every other size on the menu.
Is it just me, but since they're like in those tiny plastic bags, I always imagine some disgruntled employee just pulling out a handful of curly fries and just putting as many in as he can and just handing it to me?
Just smushing it in.
Though, when I only get like 5 in there, they must just be like...
There's no way they use a scoop just for like those little plastic bags. For like at least the board tins, I can imagine them like scooping or something, but like the paper one, they just... I'm certain they handle it.
What they do is the fry cook looks over at the person ordering and decides right then and there if they like them or not.
Oh, yeah, I'm sure.
It's the greatest level of judgment. Oh, yeah, you literally go there.
Oh, yeah, mean mug them the whole time.
Trying to intimidate them.
Oh, yeah, man, show up angry.
Angry?
I live for curly fries.
But what happens is, what it is that you order the curly fry, the value curly fry, and then you get it, you look inside, and you see that one stray regular fry.
Oh, man.
See,
so
here's the thing. When you get fries and you get, like, a bonus onion ring from Burger King, that's, like, the best thing ever.
It's the one ring. It found itself to me.
Oh, right? When you get onion rings and you get a bonus fry in there, it's just disappointing.
Yeah, no.
I've just been ripped off.
It's the fry cook looking over at you.
So, are you? Is that the end of your attempt? Too salty?
Hashtag too salty.
How much sodium does this contain?
Don't look up that hashtag. In hindsight.
Holy shit.
It was a serving.
Fortunately for you, 8 fluid ounces.
Oh, well, thank God. How much is in there? Okay, 32 fluid ounces. All right, so.
So you're safe.
A quarter.
Because one serving, which is 8 fluid ounces,
I don't feel well.
Contains 790 milligrams of sodium, which is 33% of your daily intake.
So not quite like Chinese food level, but.
Who the hell?
I'll go look. I have Clamato on my breath.
If it's a Jehovah's Witness, go.
All right, let's wrap this video up.
Yeah, because I don't feel good anymore. Hey, at least it's only 60 calories per serving.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, so that was the Clamato Chug. If we didn't explain it before, this is a toxic concoction of tomato and clam juice.
Clamato. Tastes like dick cheese.
Right.
Now at your local CVS, there's no way they sell that shit in actual stores. So if you're looking for it, I mean, like that corner store that you have, the Korean dude owns that probably does drugs, I'm sure he sells Clamato. It's got to be expired.
Yeah, I was going to say.
I mean, it's basically.
And God bless you if you find it in the mall like we did, because 9 times out of 10 it's going to be a rusty can.
They just, like, fucking pocket Clamato you and just hand it to you by hand.
Actually, I'm pretty sure.
Pour that shit in your mouth.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure they take old tin cans, cut them open, put clam juice and tomato juice together, and then solder the can back together.
Or they just use the three seashell method to just scoop it.
Scoop it, yeah.
Yeah, look up how the three seashells actually work, internet. It's quite disgusting.
Why? Do they put those through the dishwasher?
Yeah, I don't even know.
No, they're supposed to flush them, and then presumably another set materializes.
It's like, well, where do they go? Nobody really knows.
Yeah,
not true. Oh my God, I don't feel well.
I really kind of want to put the diagram in the video now of how they work, but...
No, let them learn.
Yeah, let them learn. Okay.
That said, I really don't feel well.
Well, since Tesla doesn't feel good, let's wrap this one up. We have something else we can record.
This sombrero is getting hot.
Yeah.
Just like this picante Clamato juice. Oh, man, it really burns.
Well, that was the Clamato Chug, ladies and gentlemen. We'll probably never, ever see this shit again.
This episode of Science to Say brought to you from Guadalajara.
Oh, dude, now I gotta put, like, a backpack. And
come for the Clamato juice. Stay for the murders.
Sorry, Guadalajara.
You've been dadded.
You've been dadded. Alright, I think that's it for this one. So, hope you enjoyed. Until next time,
you stay well.
You well.
Hey everyone, I am the Sega.
And I am the Tesla. And someone's out of frame.
Oh,
it
might be.
His Airbnb.
Oh God, fuck off with Airbnb. Alright, that's an outtake.
No, it's not.
Hold on. Redo it. Tore my groin. These fucking desert boots.
Did you post yourself on the...
Fucking Christ, I think I hit the floor with my grundle. Alright.
I got rug burns on my grundle!
God damn.
Hey everyone, I'm the Sagan.
I'm the Tesla.
And I'm the Darwin.
And this is the Clamato Chug. Oh, well, fuck. I was so ready to do like the jackass.
Yeah! Yeah.
Which, yeah, okay. Sorry.
Well, now I'm open. Oh, it's yours. Yeah.
Still do it.
What the hell?
Hashtag phone burn.
Fanam.
I'm waiting.
Grundle burn.
Waiting for.
Hashtag grundle burn.
Hashtag grundle stiltskin. I'm waiting for Tesla to be like, you know, I don't really like tomatoes, and then our opening's fucking the Always Sunny, like, Clamato Chug.
Oh, God. The irony is, I never liked children too.
God, I fucking hate tomatoes. Thank you. with the rim.
Give me a cup.
You gotta chug half of it. Give me a cup. And then you just pour the Clamato into it and like shake.
I don't know. That's what's throwing up.